दिस इज इंग्लिश शॉर्ट हैंड डिक्टेशन नंबर 130 एंड द डिक्टेशन स्पीड इज 160 वर्ड्स पर मिनट. रेडी स्टार्ट. ऑनरेबल चेयरमैन सर, द सब्जेक्ट मैटर ऑफ दिस बिल इज ऑफ ग्रेव इम्पॉर्टेंस टू आवर नेशनल सिक्योरिटी एंड टू द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ आवर कंट्री. इवन दो वी आर ओनली द सेकेंड कंट्री इन द होल वर्ल्ड टू हैव मोर देन ए बिलियन पॉपुलेशन, वी आर स्टिल ए डेवलपिंग कंट्री. वी स्टिल हैव ए कंस्ट्रेंट ऑन रिसोर्सेज. वेरी रिसेंटली ए फ्यू मंथ्स एगो वेन द US प्रेजिडेंट वॉज हियर, ही अनाउंस्ड दैट इंडिया इज नो लॉन्गर ए डेवलपिंग कंट्री एंड इट इज ए डेवलप्ड कंट्री. वाइल सच सेंटिमेंट्स मे बी ए मैटर ऑफ प्राइड फॉर अस, द फैक्ट रिमेन्स दैट वी आर समवेयर इन बिटवीन. We are not a fully developed country because we have hundreds of millions of our citizens who are deprived of basic necessities. We do have to take pride in that aspect of our country which is world class, which is admired by the rest of the world. That part of our economy can compete with any other country in the world. But the fact remains that we have hundreds of millions of Indians who are deprived of basic necessities. People from other countries who may have originally come to our country legally but have stayed on illegally have an insidious effect on our nation's development because our huge population strains the resources. Just now, before I introduced my bill, this House has had a very deep and long discussion on the matter of child labor and the various facilities that are being provided. And in the conclusion, we were just coming to the point about how much more still needs to be done. When we talk about how much more needs to be done for the children of India and for other deprived citizens of India, we have to give priority to citizens of India. We do have a big heart for people who are suffering in other countries. Even though we are still a developing country, even though we are transitioning into a country which can take pride in becoming a developed country, we have contributed to other countries and to the citizens of other countries who have gone through difficulties. I remember a few years ago when the tsunami hit Southeast Asia, when countries in this part of the world got hit very badly, India was one of the first countries to respond, to contribute financially and to contribute other resources to help out unfortunate citizens of the affected countries. Only a couple of years ago, when there was a major earthquake in Pakistan, India was one of the first to offer substantial amount of money and other help to citizens of Pakistan who were affected by this natural disaster. We have done more than that. 6 or 7 years ago, when a hurricane devastated the southern part of the United States, which is the most developed country in the world, India was one of the first countries to offer help to the citizens of the United States. We have compassion for people of the world wherever they are. But when it comes to running our own country, when it comes to giving priority to the citizens of our own country, we sometimes forget that we must give priority to the citizens of India over those who are in this country illegally. Sir, the problem of illegal immigration is widespread. Official and semi-official estimates state that there are at least 20 million illegal immigrants in this country. Madam, it is a very precise statement. The only point that is to be picked up is that the government has not taken any decision in this regard. That means the government has not taken a decision now, but it may take a decision in the future. The question of foreign direct investment in retail trade is open. I rise to raise a serious concern of about 8 crore small businessmen, peddlers, pavement sellers in this country who are mostly self-employed and who are living by the proceeds of sale of their goods in the open market. They are all very consumer friendly. While there are a number of issues on the national agenda which requires urgent attention of the government, why has the government thought it so important to pick it up for immediate discussion in the country? What is the hurry? A discussion paper has been circulated, opinions have been sought, an inter-ministerial committee has been set up and it has also given its report. But as far as I know, 2/3 of the respondents have given their opinion in the negative, which means that most of the people who are asked to give the opinion have said that there should not be any foreign direct investment in retail sector. Secondly, most of those who concurred with the foreign direct investment in retail sector are having supply chains, which means they are interested parties, and if foreign direct investment is brought in, they will get necessary support from foreign direct investment. Unorganized retail trade players in the whole country, beginning from hawkers to medium-sized shops to district-level industry, have refused to buy the idea that if foreign players are allowed to come in, they will invest in the infrastructure. Nobody believes that Walmart will be interested in setting up infrastructure in the country to help the chain of supply. There are a number of apprehensions that I wish to share with the Honorable Minister so that there can be other side of the views also, and the government may come to an objective decision on this issue. I am not going to the larger issue of liberalization of foreign direct investment, on which there are differences. I am simply raising the issue whether foreign direct investment should be brought in the retail sector in order to strengthen the supply chain of the country. It is being said that farmers will be benefited. Let me mention here that a recent survey of American market and the European market has said that the giants never give their benefit to the farmers. The second point is that there might be a decline in the price of food products. The reality is just the reverse. The big players never give up their profit. Thirdly, there is a belief that they can create more jobs. That is also not true. They are all capital intensive, and since they are all capital intensive, it is not likely that jobs would increase. Fourthly, the apprehension is that there will be an unequal competition. How a small trader would compete with the Walmart? Liberalization always talks about level playing ground, and that was the philosophy propounded. Now it seems that there is going to be unequal competition. Some big Indian players were allowed to enter retail trade instead of the foreign players, but that has not improved the situation. There is no reduction in the wastage, and farmers have not been benefited. They believe that the gap between the income of farmers and the income of retail would be narrowed down. That is not correct. Everybody knows that farmers in the country are suffering seriously from underpayment. Will American multinational companies do for India what Indian multinational companies have not been able to do for India? Are they coming for philanthropy? The Prime Minister has said that there is a need to strengthen the supply chain, and I agree with that. But I believe that in order to strengthen the supply chain, it is not necessary to invite the foreign multinationals, but to strengthen the Indian small traders. They do not get the finance. You should give easy credit, marketing facilities, and road transport to small traders. In order to strengthen the supply chain and to tame inflation, you need to do that. I agree with what the Prime Minister says and what the government says. But what should be done for that? It is not to invite the Walmart, but to strengthen the economic strength of the Indian small traders, which has not been done. The fate of 8 crore people and their employees is in serious jeopardy. I do not impute any motives to the move of the government to invite the foreign direct investment in the retail sector. But what is the fact? The fact is that the total turnover in the retail trade was rupees 12 lakh crore earlier, but now it is rupees 19 lakh crore. Indian market happens to be even larger than China. China is not that open, but India is open. I welcome the openness. India is the largest unexplored consumer market in the world. That is why there is an eye on the retail trade by the foreign direct investment players, because they are in trouble in Europe. There is economic stagnation. That is why their lobbyists in India are lobbying seriously to get foreign direct investment in retail trade cleared by the government. It seems that the discussion that has been initiated by the government is preset. I plead for caution with the government. The key panel which was set up has not yet recommended the induction of foreign direct investment in the retail trade. Most of the players are against it. I plead with the government not to take a hasty decision, not to take into account the business interests of the foreign multinationals in this country. We have to protect the national interest. Not only that, the interests of small traders are also to be protected in the situation of mounting unemployment. We should not seal the fate of the self-employed traders.